Hey folks, in this video you're going to see the Brazilian physicist Marcia Barbosa in a TED talk that she gave. Now, I don't know what she believes, whether she believes in creation or evolution, but it's interesting what she has to say because she is going to be describing how man is now and will be in the future using technology from God found in a beetle to filter water, to provide fresh drinking water for more of the people on the planet, especially in arid places. Now, I don't believe that she is thinking when she describes this technology that, or realizing perhaps even, that she's describing man's use of God's technology, but this is what she is doing. And man has mimicked God's technology in many, many ways, many times. There is an actual field of science where scientists study the properties of life on the planet, and then they mimic a feature or ability of one of God's creations, and they come up with man-made technologies to mimic that are useful to mankind. Many, many cases exist, and man continues to do it. There's an actual field of science devoted to this. So here in this talk, you'll hear her describe how God's technology and the design of a specific species of beetle is going to be employed in the future more fully to provide fresh drinking water.
This beetle from the desert of Africa, this animal is capable of capturing the vapor air, transforming liquid water, and drink it. Come on, how does animal does that? In the back of the animal, they have an upper surface in which they have molecules that loves water. And they love so badly that they transform vapor into liquid, what actually requires energy. And then they have a second layer that hates water. So when the particles, liquid water, comes to the second layer, they just slide as the water is spilling in your sofa that you cover with the polymer surface to avoid to be wetted. And then the animal is so smart, this beetle, that he just lean to the front and the water just come directly to its mouth. It's not perfect. Nature is perfect. So now our group is developing a combination of the two mechanisms. We have nanotubes in water, flow fast, and the top of the nanotube loves water, and the down part of the nanotube hates water, and we are going to use that to transform vapor into liquid and to storage. So stay tuned, and years from now, water in nanotubes will solve the problem of lack of fresh water in the planet. Thank you very much.